So he's handsome. Very creative, loving guy. He's a brilliant drummer as well. But Chris, on the other hand.
He goes there.
Just for everyone who doesn't know my brother, he played the drums. My older brother.
Yeah.
Chris is my second favourite C word in the English language. My first, of course, being celebrity. You all thought I was going to say constable, didn't you?
Oh, Jesus Christ.
He's not going to help you.
How's Danny supposed to follow this?
Love? Oh no, who can follow this possible? Love is something that just happens to you. It's out of your control. It's like a Will Craft before that speech. by a talented orator. Something just flows over you like a salt and shower. Happiness and joy.
Shattered.
Danny. I forgot you were here. I'm just telling you, enjoying it. I can't believe I was so nervous. I wouldn't be so nervous if I wasn't so hungover. Unorganised, ill-prepared, and irresponsible. If it wasn't for those little details, this would have been the best speech of all time. But I'm going to do my best.
Take your time, brother. Take your time.
Maybe that one, guys. I'm trying to keep the connection going. Also,
we're just warming up.
This is actually probably one of the strongest people I've ever met. His endurance is remarkable. In terms of strength, it's compared to me, it's like a Ringo Starr in a songwriting competition with John Lennon. Hey, everybody. Look, Ringo's just written a song. Paul's like, that's great, Ringo. Just stick it up on the fridge where everyone can see. But seriously, the things he's had to endure over the years, all the torture and the feedings, all the teasing, and the mocking. That's true. I'm surprised he's alive. I remember this one trip. That was back in the 60s. We were at the Botanic Gardens and I still feel so guilty about it. Guilt's one of the strongest motivators in my life. So. I'm putting out a book, it's entitled How to Love Your Guilt. But that's not later in the year. I wrote the Botanical Gardens and Chris was, there was this huge fence, the big fence around the Botanical Gardens, it's like big spears, And he was climbing over this fence, which turned out to be a gate. And he was sort of right, I climbed over first and I got over and then he did it. And I realised, this gate's open. Like, it's unlocked. And he was at the top and I pushed it open and he slipped. And it sort of skewered his leg with the spear. Yeah, and he showed me the scar. So I thought, get up, you pussy. Like, it's not that bad. Anyway, he showed me the scar. And it's all the huge gaping wound in his leg. And, as you do when you're a kid, freak out. I just ran. And I didn't stop running. Until this last week. Inside, I'm running. My mom was running away. Inside, poor mum. But, look, there's one. How did that happen? But there was... Yeah, that felt... I'm sorry about that. I'm not sure if I apologise, but... I'll try to wind it up. It's getting...
Do an hour!
Okay. Well, there was this... Think this little soft toy that he had. and this kid called Daffy Duck. And for some reason, the manufacturers, they made the eyes so you could rotate them. And this used to drive Chris just fucking mental. Because I used to take full advantage and twist the eyes around. This is the normal configuration of the eyes. The next configuration, which I remember, called One Eye to the Sky. You get the idea. And my old favourite, I call it The Introspection. But it was just merciless. This could go on for years. And still got the toy. And Chris, guess what? No, I'm just kidding. I guess it's inevitable that, you know, you've got an organic chemist and an electrician, that the chemistry between them is going to be electric. But it's the love that they have for each other that is, that's brought us all here tonight, and, which is great. And I'd also like to speak on behalf of someone who isn't with us tonight, who's not here at the time.
Another 20 minutes.
Okay. Look, everyone would be outstanding to, it says here, eat toast, but I think that's just a typo. I think if you could spray that glasses and make a toast to the bride and groom, Mr. and Mrs. Putnam, Taylor. I said everyone would be outstanding. Come on, guys. Yeah! Mr. Chris and Michelle. Yeah!